Bus day is this?
Bus day demolition 4 or 5. I'm not sure anymore. It's the day that I'm keeping a little bit of distance from time because it was take out the toilet day.
This is Mella.
This is Dunn.
And we're sharing our experience as we reinvent our habitat.
And he hasn't cleaned up yet, and I have, so I didn't do much today, but Don and his dad did an awesome job taking out the toilet.
Pretty cold, like, I don't know, in the 50s, rainy. Today we're trying to pull out the stainless steel encasing that is the old lavatory. The water tanks and the chemical tank, where that's where the poo goes in. So it's not gonna be a fun day as it is. The rain's gonna make it a little more challenging, I think.
Designed this toilet made it nearly impossible to take out. Beginning of the day was pretty tough because getting that gigantic one piece of stainless steel that is the bathroom removed from the walls was so difficult.
Just put in there to stay in there.
Yes.
Yeah, you can't pull anymore because of the tank, like you're just pulling against this.
Like I had to get up on top of it and jump and push and kick off from the wall to get it to come out.
Took some brute force.
Had my first real injury. My hands kind of swollen up. So I worked through the day, my hands hurting. Mella got some ice for me and I packed ice on it for a little while, but I just can't leave my dad to work on the bus by himself. I'm a little worried about going to do Pilates tomorrow.
You can do Pilates.
Can I do one hand Pilates?
Yeah, you do it without the arms.
Okay.
It's okay.
Big humper here.
Mella did some unscrewing and unbolting of some of the leftover side paneling. Woohoo! The entire stainless steel tank has these metal bands that are fastened up into the frame, but then over that, it's riveted in, covered in fiberglass. So there's no good way to take the bolts out without trying to like tear the fiberglass off the side, and it was hard to figure out how to get it down and where it was fastened because you couldn't see any of it, and it was a toilet. So I had my head in a toilet. I was upside down, hanging in a toilet, trying to unfasten it. It stinks. Other exciting news, we've got the trailer full of trash now.
Yeah, it's kind of overflowing. It's amazing to see like it all come out, and it looks like so much more when it's separated into its parts, right? That's all gotta go somewhere now.
We do have some big piles.
Bunch of metal that's, you know, all reusable, recyclable, which we're gonna try and sell to the recycling. That's a lot of metal.
I think aluminum was 60 cents a pound, and we got a lot of aluminum.
A lot.
Yeah, if you want to guess how much aluminum we got, write it down in the comment, and at another date, we'll tell you. Maybe we'll give away a little plaque from inside the bus to whoever gets it properly guessed. Or whoever's the closest without going over. Isn't that how they do it on Wheel of Fortune?
It's chilly. It's been a cold day. Like 2 days ago, we were sweating like dying in the bus because it was like a sauna in there. And now it's freezing cold. It's crazy. It's so back and forth.
Yeah, weather. We have lived in California for the last 20 years, both of us. So being in the Midwest and feeling weather is wacky. So the next thing we're gonna try to accomplish is to pull out the fiberglass sides inside the bus and then remove that big board insulation so it won't be nearly as messy as the ceiling insulation, which Mella loved.
When do we do the floors?
After we do that.
So walls and then floors.
Yep. I really felt great when we first bought the bus because we couldn't see any rust anywhere. As we're pulling things down, we're starting to see a little bit of surface rust. And today, tearing out some flooring around the toilet area, we really saw some wet insulation that was rusting out some of the stud beams, the metal stud beams. The frame still looks nice and solid, but the rust around those areas, it's a little sad because the rest of the bus looked immaculate. I was really hoping that nobody had spilled and let water stand in there, but it looks like that's what happened in the bathroom, and it was still, there was water in there.
But it looks manageable.
But we got to tear a lot more floor out, so I'm hoping that we don't reveal a lot more rust.
Hopefully it's just around the bathroom where the water was. I'm guessing the rest good.
I'm hopeful, but reserving judgment to be thrilled about it. So that's what we're doing next time.
Yeah, you can't believe how dirty it gets, like behind the wall of the bus, right? Like, I thought there would be nothing there.
It was just a mound of nastiness.
So gross.